Hi, creators. Welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica, and I am your guide through cleaning up some messy geometry. In this video tutorial, we're going to go over how to get rid of these pesky spirals that are causing this really nice looking model to have really weird geometry. So I'm going to show you how to not only reduce your mesh, but also how to get rid of those spirals. If you're new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and clean up this mesh and also reduce it. So here we have our character, and she's looking really cute and all. But the issue is that I want to reduce her mesh, and usually what I do is I just double click and get rid of some edges. But unfortunately, when I double click, this model was probably ZRemeshed in ZBrush, and therefore when it was done this way, it created it like this. So some people may be able to go back into ZBrush and fix it. This has already been UV mapped and textured, so I might as well just go ahead and reduce the mesh and clean up those spirals. Now let's find out how many polygons this character has. We go to display, let's go to heads up display, and then we're gonna go to poly count, and you can see that she has about 3,800 faces and she's got 7,600 tries. All right. Let's see how we can clean this up. So the issue again is I go to edges and I double click. You can see that it creates a spiral. So to clean up the spiral, we're going to use something fancy. Not that fancy. It's the mesh tool called Target Weld. The long way is mesh tools Target Weld. Or you can shift right click and then go to Target Weld. And what I want you to do is just basically go to every other vertex and combine them like so. It's gonna look a little weird, but there is a method to the madness. So what this does is that when I go to edges and I double click, you can see that I now have an edge loop, but we also have a couple of other ones as well, and they are not connected. So that's the one you want to delete. So I'm going to select these edges, then I'm going to do a control delete in my keyboard. If you guys want the long way, you can double click this loop and then go to edit mesh, delete edge vertex. So this is very important. Don't just click delete on your keyboard, because if you do, it's just going to give you n-gons plus a bunch of floating vertices. Instead, what we're going to do is go to edges and do a control delete, or edit mesh, delete edge and vertex. So that means that it deletes the edge and the vertex. And you can see what happens is that we are starting to get edge loops. So I'm going to go ahead and just double click on that one, control delete. Now you might want to straighten these UVs. It's a little weird to have this going like in this direction, but if you want to, you can select those edges and go to the scale by hitting R and then just kind of bring in one of them closer together. Now it is going to manipulate the mesh. And also, as you can see, it's skewing the UV. So this is something that probably should have been done before the character was UV mapped and before it was textured. I am going to fix the UVs just to show you how you can go around it, but just want to let you know that this will mess up your UVs a little bit. So go ahead and go through and do a control delete. And I'm going to go ahead and control delete again. And then when I go and do this again, and now you have edge loops all the way along. Now, again, this mesh is pretty interesting, so it has some weird other problems, but in general that should get me going. So I'm going to go ahead and just press R and squish these guys together, so at least it's a nice grid patterned and they're nice and straight. And there you go. Now you also can tell that you can probably clean up a little bit of the mesh, so I'm going to show you another trick, which is found in the modeling toolkit. So up here at the top we have a modeling toolkit, and if you guys scroll down, there's something called quad draw. And then if you hold down shift, you can see that the manipulator of the mouse changes to relax, and that will relax the mesh. So again, this is something that should be done in the mesh mode, right? When you're in the modeling phase, but you know, this is what I have, and so I'm trying to clean it up. All right, so that cleans up the mesh a bit. Then I'm gonna go to workspace, go and do a pull down for UV editing. And this is where my UVs come in. So you can see that there is the models here. You can see the UVs have been pulled. So let's right click, go to faces, double click. And you can see that I'm still in quad draw. It won't let me actually choose faces. So you want to get out of that tool by clicking anywhere, such as the selection tool up here at the top, or you can just press Q. Okay, now we can go to faces. Now we can double click and then shift right click, unfold, unfold. And now your UVs are set. Now this will warp them a little bit, so you might have to kind of, you know, make sure that the mesh is inside the space. Maybe scale it down a little bit, or maybe potentially grab these guys and kind of maybe nudge them a little bit if your model is that flexible. Right? And there you go. Now the UVs, the texture is looking better and doesn't look like it's stretched. And now you have a lower polygon model. So now we're down to 3,700 faces. So then I would repeat this process on this side. Now this model is not symmetrical, so this would have to be repeated on this end. It didn't take very long, so let me go ahead and do it again. Shift right click, target weld, and then we're just gonna go click, 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 click and drag. Then we're gonna go to edges and find out where is the loop. Right, so this is the loop, so therefore I can get rid of this one, control delete. Get rid of this one that goes all the way to the other edge, so control delete. And this one, control delete. Let me go back to general so you guys can see a little bit better. Then we can go ahead and do this. Control delete. And keep doing that until we get our quad. So again, this is just, it's always better to do this before you're modeling or UV mapping or texturing. So it's really important to make sure that you pay attention to that. But in general, this can be one option in case you just get a really funky model. This is one way you can clean it up. I've worked in the industry where I've received some really weird models and I said, you know, I can just retop it. I can do it. And they're like, no, just so I have to fix it. And at least I know how, right? Anything in 3D can be fixed. All right. So again, let's go to quad draw. I'm going to go ahead and hold down shift and wiggle it around to get this nice smoother mesh. And now we've dropped it down to 3,500 faces and 7,000 tries. Now there's other places that I have spirals that I can continue reducing. So for example, here I have a spiral, so I can do the same. Shift right click, target weld, and go to edges. This is the one I want to keep. This is the one I want to delete. And this one I want to delete as well. Then I can go to edges. And this one, maybe you need to do a little bit of modeling. And then potentially get rid of that one too, depending if it's really necessary. And then of course, I have to fix the UV. So let's jump over to UVs. Let's grab some faces. Let's see where it is. It's right here. Let's do unfold, unfold, and see maybe a little bit of sewing. Press the letter G. G, that's so. G. We'll leave that one there. And then let me try unfolding again. And then it looks like I'm going to just have to tweak it. Grab the UVs. Now this is kind of like in a corner, so not many people are going to see it. Oh, I see some edges here that probably need to be stitched together. Oh, so shift right click, sew. So unfold, unfold. And then probably tweak it, something like that. Actually, let's look at the arm. We're gonna unfold, unfold. We're gonna scale it down a little bit, nudge it. And there we go. So that is one way that you guys can not only reduce your mesh, but also get rid of those pesky spirals. Let me know what you think by leaving a comment below. Was that helpful? Any other tutorials that you would like to see? And there she is. And you can't even tell that she is a lower topology, which is the magic of it all. All right, guys, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That's your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Please share my videos. If you know somebody that's struggling in getting rid of spirals, which are those pesky spirals in your geometry, please share my videos. That would really help me out. And it would also help an artist just like you. And don't forget to take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you can find free resources, models, ebooks, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time in the next video tutorial.